Hello students, welcome back to our e-learning class. Now in our previous class, we have started to read the chapter, Why Does a Country Need a Constitution? We have read about Constituent Assembly. We have read that the Constitution serves several purposes. And the first one is, it lays out certain ideals that form the basis of kind of country that we as citizens aspire to live in. Or in the next sentence, it is again explained in this manner that, or put another way, a constitution tells us what the fundamental nature of our society is. A country is usually made up of different communities of people who share certain beliefs but may not necessarily agree on all issues. It's quite true, no? Forget about country. Just think about our family. We are living in a family. We are living with our family members. Now, do we really agree with each other in each and every matter? No, it's not possible. That means it is not possible that every time we will be just ready to accept other members. That means our brothers or our parents, or they are just saying something. Now every time it is not possible for us to agree with them. Just on the other hand, it is also not possible for our parents or other family members just to agree with our thoughts, agree with our opinions, agree with our feelings every time. It's not possible. So when it is not possible in our family, how can it be possible in a large society? How can it be possible in a country like India, where such diversities are there? So this is the work of Constitution. It helps us to just follow some definite, distinct guidelines, principles, following which we can just live in an amicable environment. That means we can live in peace, we can live in harmony. A constitution helps serve as a set of rules and principles that all persons in a country can agree upon as the basis of the way in which they want the country to be governed. This includes not only the type of government but also an agreement on certain ideals. Ideals meaning, I think you know, it is like this, a standard or principle to be aimed at, that they all believe the country should be upheld. So just let us read once more the last sentence. This includes not only the type of government but also an agreement on certain ideals that they all believe the country should uphold. That means some definite rules, some definite ideas where we can just agree with each other. We will not feel that, yes, we are underprivileged, or somebody is just enjoying so much of authority, so much of privileges. We can just live in harmony following these rules. We can just agree with each other. Okay children, now it's time to say you bye. So in our next video, we will proceed with the next part of the chapter. Still then, bye. Bye everybody.